smash my hand, bang, if I hit him like that, bang, it'll go down, bang, and then it'll come back and like that. One particular application of it. This is right now, we're using it as a coordination exercise. That's one, two, three, and then like that. Okay, now why we have to dive it up like that? Actually, we're pointing. But for training for safety, you just put it up here, because all you have to do is an exam like that. All right, any questions? One, two, three, answer. Okay, then go back to the first drill that you started like that, see? And then answer. Okay, we combine the first two drills now, okay? All right, this is your coordination exercise. The two line and the four line, okay? Okay, well, let's say we're doing regular sobriety. In reality, you already know we're in this range, we're gonna smash the hand. Or we're gonna thrust up the hand or slash the hand, okay? That's your basic sobriety, okay? But I'm gonna add the combination. One thrust here and one backhand here. Okay? Then I'm gonna add the next series. See, when you go like that, and I block, I go one here and I go down here. Okay, I'm just gonna add two things, then the other side will do it. Okay, so what I'm trying to say is that the minute you block here, usually you return the stick. From here, right, you're gonna return the dagger and then either hit the high backhand and maybe hit here and then go right back in the flow. Right, instead of returning the stick. Okay, so when the combination comes back, I go one and then go down low. All right, any questions? And they'll do the same to you. Okay, this is basic sombrato. The basic sombrato is very, very important. Okay, so when I go like that, and I go back, 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 okay, and back into here. Okay. Or my attack could be here, back, and she picks it up. Then the other side will keep the same back. Or I hit here, then I hit here, and then I hit here. And I come back and flow. One side is getting the reaction time. Okay, so for 1 minute and a half, one side will feed the diagonal return. Usually you go a rook block and return one stick, a stick and strike. This one you can go a rook block, bait the stick, blow the diagonal, go down the stick here, back to the floor here. Okay, any questions? Okay, let's try it up to here. Okay, just to smash the hand so you don't have to exchange, okay? So we're gonna go into the section, okay? So you have this one over here, you have a switch. Now the switches can be done two ways. You have a quick switch, which is you crash and you go like this. And then you have what they call low to high switch, which is like this. All right. You have the switch in here and you have a full safe. A full safe means that your diver starts at 12 o'clock and ends completely at 12 o'clock. And then you can do anything to the diver when it comes out. Okay? That is the first one. That's switch and hit. That means when you switch, there is a hitting of the temple over here, could be a thrust here, and then you go one revolution, see, and then come all the way down. That's 12 to 12. All right, then you go into what we call the half snakes. The half snakes means that they start at 12 and usually end at 6 or 7. Right, so that when you go like this and you hit here and you smash the hand, see, it just moves off into 6 o'clock or 7 o'clock on the strip. That is what they call a half snake. There's a difference. If possible, you should always do what they refer to as, see how that stabs here? And then you just sail it over here like that. All right, that's the half snake. Okay, I'm gonna give you this version over here. Your two, one basic is the puño, which is this sort, is under the arm, see? And you just grip it like that, all right? And then the other one is when the puño, this section here, like that, half here, is over the arm, and you grip it like that, and then you just come into your action, which is usually this, or this, and this, and this, or just bang, 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 just smash the person. All right, I wanna take those number two and number three. Okay, any questions on number two and number three? The first one is what? Switch, this is the switch, right? And bang, see, full snake, bang. If they still have the dagger, then you just whip on it with the stick, okay? And the half snake, is when you make contact and you hit. And when you hit the diver and hit the head, you put the puño here. Puño's on top, and then you just eject it like that. Right? The other one is when the puño is underneath the arm. The puño underneath the arm is like that. See? And then you just go like that. You can just smash the hand like that, take it off, see? And then go back like that. All right, any questions? See? So we're gonna do number two and number three. Any questions on that? Okay, let's go about 30 minutes, and then we'll go into...
Pardon me?
Hey, Jeff.
Oh,
yeah.
See, that's already here. So this is the
and we to the stick here as a support. So when you switch over here, this is the stab here in the armpit, and this is the crash of a training, like that. Okay, that's what they call switch and downward strip. See what I'm doing? Stab, switch, and downward strip. Okay, then you have the other one, which is called number six, okay, is pull. You see the hand, and you hit, and you just go like that. You pull, and you strip. Okay, and you can always beat that to the point because you have the timing there. All right, can we just try that for 2 minutes? Okay, so we're going to move to number five, which is switch and pull. Then you have the switch and the downward strip. That's the downward strip. Don't stay here because if you stay down here, see the diver is going to come in. Right, so what you want to do is after you make the hit here, see, then you switch. See, because in position, because if you sidekick, see where the diver is? This will leap first, and then that will tap again. See, when you're ready here, ready to receive that. You take off. All right? Okay, let's try that for about 2 minutes. But you're going to snake the stick, okay? So this motion here, you're going to snake the stick counterclockwise, then bridge. That means you raise the stick up. Then you snake clockwise the dagger. Okay. I'm going to give you three variations on this. Okay, when she does this, this is the snake. See? And then it comes all the way out like that. That's the first one, because you're going to try to strip it completely out. Okay, now, the variation, if the mechanics of the strip failed and they went down, that is now the snake, okay? Notice that she goes clockwise here, snake, and we just nickname it Pukyu. So she's coming out, this is a slash on the hand here like that. All right, this diagonal's really out because you already hit the hand, but if it isn't, they just push it toward the face here or the throat. All right, now, the second one is what we call Bankau, or the spear, because you support it. Is identical to the same motion like that. See the hand? Stab. And she comes across. See how she supports it? See how she brings it down? Okay, see what it is? That's it like that. That's it. I can't tap this. All right, now, this third one is you want to strip and you lock up the bent elbow. One, see the bridge? See the right here? And then stab here. See? Now you see where your hand is coming over here? Then she pulls it here. And this one locks to that position. Okay. All right. Any questions on the three bases from that motion?
Third.
See, when you go like that, and you bridge it, see the hand? See how you pick it up? You like that. All right. Any questions? That could be a straight arm bar, it could be a man arm bar. All right. So you have the pull cue. You have this. Okay, and then you have the locking up, okay, into the bent elbow lock. Okay, yes?
Can you do it turn to the side?
Sure. All right, I'm going to have Paula do it. One, see? Okay, see how she bridges it? She's bridging it. All right, the first one, she just puts it right on the radial nerve here on the wrist, see? Now, if he's still holding the dagger, see, this, usually they won't. That's a slash on the neck. It's already done. This is just so you can learn the body again to that. All right? Then the second one is with the, since you're doing, she's supporting the diagonal like this. Okay, that's it. Okay. Then the third one is it comes around. See? Can you see it from here? All right. See how she comes over here? See how she, how the knife comes up? Okay. It can be a wrist lock or it can be an elbow lock. Depending what you want. All right, any questions on the three variations from that route? Okay, all right, let's try those three. Lift it, see, bang. See, that should be over with anyway. See, so when you go like that, you have like five different locks here. See, but when you want to do that, when you see how you cut it here? And then the real cut, see, it sort of bends it, and then you go bang. See the crazy bone here? That's why the stick is no longer there, see? And you just put it like that, see? And that's all you're doing, see? You have to lock it like that. See, then you can go into this lock. This one here is very painful when you put it on, because they go here. See, and when you see how it tightens up quickly.
Oh, yeah.
See, and this, see, because the stick is added lever and it makes it more painful. Okay, you got it? Okay, that's, I think that's the problem we were having. Everyone had the first and second one down. I think the third one was sort of just foaming around. If you miss it, see, and you will miss it, then just go to this one. See the hand. You just put it here. See. See the lock here? Now you go into this one here like that.